There's a rush to nail down divorce deals by New Year's Eve. Beginning in 2019, alimony will no longer be tax deductible by the spouse making those alimony payments. At the same time, the recipient of what's called spousal maintenance will no longer declare those payments as taxable income. This will help fund tax cuts for corporate America that were enacted by the 2017 tax reform. That's a mouthful. Joining me now is to explain how this is going to affect people getting a divorce, divorce attorney Lawrence Datz. Here's the bottom line. The big winner here is the federal government.
That's a fact. Historically, the person who paid the alimony usually had the higher income and paid a higher tax rate. The person who was receiving it, a lower income and a lower tax rate. And so the alimony allowed them to save the difference between the two.
So a lot of the articles I've read said people are going to be rushing to get divorced. There may be a way, and we don't know for sure, to get around this. Say divorcing couples agree on very little, but they may agree on a settlement. Say a divorcing couple says, we can agree upon a settlement agreement before the end of the year, but the divorce isn't finalized. May that be a way to be grandfathered into the old rules?
Yes. The new law refers to an instrument rather than a judgment. And so a written settlement agreement may qualify as an instrument and allow the old alimony law to stay in effect.
Now, if I've been divorced for the past 5 years, are things going to change as far as my tax burden?
No. The new law specifically refers to modifications, and so if a person had a prior divorce judgment or settlement agreement or even a premarital agreement for that matter that already referred to the deductibility of alimony, it stays in place.
And look, the reality here is that taxes do come into play. So when a party is negotiating the spousal maintenance, the alimony settlement, is it possible that down the road when the rules have changed, one party may say, okay, you had been bearing the tax burden before, we can go ahead and make things more fair by reducing the amount of alimony that I pay you to accommodate what would have been that tax burden. Is that a negotiating tactic?
Absolutely. As far as divorcing couples are concerned, and just the practical realities, everybody's concerned with the bottom line. The person who pays wants to know how much it is they're paying out. The person who receives wants to know how much they get to spend. And so, the change in the law will make it actually much clearer. Okay, it may not be more fair and it may not save tax money, but it'll be clear. If a person pays $100, the other person's going to receive $100.
And people have to understand that a divorce is basically a business transaction. And in every business transaction, there is a negotiation that goes on. And in negotiations, not everybody gets what they want.
Absolutely true also. I tell my clients, that in the outcome, nobody is happy. The idea is just to be satisfied.
Can you tell? It's not that I've been through this before. It's just that I have great understanding of it. Lawrence Datz, thanks for some eye-opening information. And that is the bottom line. Go into this knowing what the reality is and with an open mind. If you missed any of this information, go to newsforjax.com. We'll post this interview as well as a complete breakdown of the changes.